just lift up with Jesus, make me whole.
Thank you. May be seated. If you would take your Bibles this morning and turn with me to the Gospel of John, chapter number 16. John chapter 16 this morning. We're at 3015 Upper Peachtree Road, Murphy, North Carolina, 28906. If you're in the local community here, you need a ride to church, 837-6891. That's the number to dial, 837-6891. UpperPeachtreeBaptistChurch.com on the internet. You can tune in there and you can listen to our church services. You can watch the Sunday morning church services. WCVP, WCNG, local radio stations, AM and FM, Sunday mornings at 8:30, Tri-State Baptist Hour. Tune in and be with us. John chapter number 16 today, and beginning in verse number 16. The Bible says this, and the Lord speaking here in the red letters. And he said, a little while, and you shall not see me. And again, a little while, and ye shall see me, because I go to the Father. Then said some of his disciples among themselves, what is this that he saith unto us, a little while, and ye shall not see me? And again, a little while, and ye shall see me, and because I go to the Father. They said therefore, what is this that he saith, a little while? We cannot tell what he saith. Now Jesus knew that they were desirous to ask him, and said unto them, do you inquire among yourselves of that I said, a little while, and ye shall not see me, and again a little while, and ye shall see me? Verily, verily, I say unto you, that ye shall weep and lament, but the world shall rejoice, and ye shall be sorrowful, but your sorrow shall be turned into joy. A woman, when she is in travail, hath sorrow, because her hour is come, but as soon as she is delivered of the child, she remembereth no more the anguish for joy that a man is born into the world. And ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy no man taketh from you. And in that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it you. Hitherto have ye asked nothing in my name. Ask, and ye shall receive. Listen at this, that your joy may be full. That your joy may be full. And I want to speak just a few minutes, Lord willing, on this subject. Joyfulness. Not joyfulness. Joyfulness. And can I just tell you this morning, the Lord wants us, me and you, to be full of joy. He does. He wants you to have joy. Well, let me ask you something this morning, friend. Do you have joy? How much joy do you have? Yeah. Does your joy come and go, or does your joy abide? Is it something that's always there? I'm not talking about feelings. We don't walk by feelings. We walk by faith. Feelings come and go. You can be happy one minute and crying the next as far as feelings go. I'm not talking about feelings. I'm talking about real joy. And this joy is one of the things that the Lord has given unto us that is going to sustain us and help us to endure to the end, like He said. Now, this week, if you sit there every day, all day, and you watch the news, these 24-hour news networks, it's plumb depressing. You see what's going on, and I know there's bad things going on in the world. Bad things going on in Israel. Bad things going on in Ukraine. Bad things going on in the United States of America. Bad things going on in Washington, D.C. But listen, for a born-again, saved-by-grace child of God, that inward man that has been born again, has been regenerated, praise God, is sealed to the day of redemption. And that inward man is the one I'm talking about this morning. I'm talking about that new man in Christ Jesus that's in you. If you've been saved, if you've never been saved, if you've never fully trusted Jesus for your salvation, you've never been born again, you don't have that new man living inside of you. But I'm going to tell you what, if you're really saved, God gives you the Holy Ghost. God Himself abiding in you in the person of the Holy Ghost. And He, the Holy Ghost, bears witness with your spirit, that spirit that has been born from above, that spirit that has been born of God, that new man that's within you. The Holy Ghost bears witness with your spirit inside you that you are the child of God. And that inward man can have full joy, full joy. Brother was talking this morning in Sunday school. If you missed it, very good Sunday school lesson Brother Jason taught this morning. And he was talking a lot about faith. A lot about faith. And he said in there that the writer of the Sunday school lesson talked about these joy boy toothy preachers with ever hair in place. They got hair, you know. Name it and claim it, believe it and receive it, blab it and grab it, you know, click it and tick it and booze it and lose it and whatever. You got all these, God wants you to have a Cadillac and you just send me a love gift of $1,000 and it'll come your way, you know. And that sounds warm and fuzzy. There's just one problem with it. It's a lie, you know. Here's the key to that, what we just said. Our Lord said this. He said, whatsoever, verse 23, He said, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, He will give it you. Well, here's the secret to that, and it's no secret. Jesus doesn't do anything in secret, okay? He said, I've walked among you openly. Everything I do, everything He said it openly. It's wrote down in the Bible for the whole wide world to hear. But here's the key to the whole thing. Turn back to John 15 and verse 7. And listen to what our Lord said. You know how important it is, how important it was to Jesus that we get this morning? He said these words that I just read to you the night before He went to the cross. After they ate supper that night, Judas had gone and left to betray Him. And our Lord is talking to the disciples and He's talking to us. And He could have said, now fellas, I got a rough day coming up tomorrow. You know, I'm going to need a little time alone and everything. He could have said, but no, He said, I got a lot of things I need to tell you before I go to Calvary tomorrow. Before I go to the cross, I need you to get this. He said, it's expedient for you that I go away. He said, if I go away, I'll send you another comforter. Who's that? God the Holy Ghost. Amen. To sustain you. He gave us two great enablers when He left. He left us His Word and He left us His Spirit. And they work in concert with one another. The Holy Ghost that's in us with the Word of God. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. Amen. Yeah. Listen at John 15, verse 7. If, here's the key to this. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. Well, if you're abiding in Christ, and His Word is abiding in you, you're not going to ask anything that's contrary to Jesus, and you're not going to ask anything that's contrary to His Word. The disciples told our Lord, said, teach us to pray. Teach us how to pray, Lord. He said, when you pray, He said, don't pray like a Pharisee to be heard of men, to be seen of men. He said, when you pray, He said, you go into a closet and shut your door, and God that hears you in secret, He'll reward you openly. Okay? And so He said, when you pray, our Father who art in heaven, and hallowed be thy name, giving praise to God. He's God and He's worthy of your praise, by the way. And a lot of us is praise deficient, and that's why we're revival deficient. Somebody say amen. Amen. You want revival, start praising God out of a pure heart. Yeah. But now listen. If you abide in Him, His Word abides in you, you'll want to pray the way that He wants us to pray. And our prayer is, our Father who art in heaven, we pray, Thy kingdom come, and Thy will be done. Our Lord Himself, just a little while later after He said these words, He went out into the Garden of Gethsemane and He said, Lord, if it's Your will, let this cup pass from me. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but Thy will be done. And there's people that get the pooch mouth at God. And it's a serious thing. They get angry with God because He didn't hear the prayer, according to them, that, Mamaw passed away and I was praying God let her live. Well, that's selfish on our part. Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you, John chapter 14, that where I am, there ye may be also. His desire is for His children to be with Him. And if it's time for Mamaw to go home and we're praying for her to stay, we're praying against His will. It's His will that we are where He is. That's why He said, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again. And I will receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Amen. Amen. And so when Mamaw crosses the river, we know we're not far behind her, praise God, and we'll all be with Jesus. But her work was done. It was time for her to go home. Her son had said it was time for her to leave this life and go home to be with Jesus, just like my day will come. Your day will come. If we've been born again, we have that hope. And so listen, if we abide in Him and He abides in us, we have access to joy. And that kind of joy that is full within us, because that's what the Lord wants. You're in John 15. Stay with me. Stay with me. Verse 7. If ye abide in me and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will and it shall be done unto you. Ask in accordance with God's will. Our will coincide with God's will. You hear me? Listen. Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit. So shall ye be my disciples. Well, what fruit is that? It's the fruit of the Spirit. And one of the attributes of that one fruit of the Spirit is joy. Love, peace, joy, and those three things go together. Come on. Amen. Listen, I'm not preaching name it and claim it, and worldly wealth and Cadillacs and big bank accounts and all those things are going to perish. They're corruptible. They're going to burn up with the rest of this world. But when all those things are reduced to cinders, the precious intangible things that you can't see with your naked eye, like what? Faith, hope, and charity. Now abide faith, hope, and charity, these three things, but the greatest of these is charity. You can't see them with the naked eye, but you know they're there. Let me ask you, friend. You can't see your faith, but do you know when you've got faith? You can't see love, but do you know when you have love? Do you know when you're loving somebody and when they're loving you? You can't see it with your eyes, but it's there, and you can't put a price on those things. What about peace? There's people that I believe would, Sister Jan, I believe there's people in this world that would sell their soul if they could just get a little peace. There's some people right now in the Gaza Strip and Ukraine over there with bombs going off and shrapnel landing on the top of their house. I believe they want peace. Friend, I'll tell you something. You men that served our nation and as veterans, you fellas that served in the military, if you were ever in a war place, I'm going to tell you something. You know who wants peace more than anybody? The guy that's getting shot at. Amen. That's right. Amen. It ain't the hippie carrying the sign up there in Washington that's protesting the war that's burning his draft car. It's the man that's down there in the foxhole with the bullets whizzing around him that's wanting peace. He's doing what the country called him to do, but he's wanting to have peace. Listen, I'm going to tell you something. You can have peace, you can have love, you can have joy, but to have it, you've got to have Jesus. You've got to have Him. And listen to what He says, that you bear much fruit. Verse 9, as the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love. You see how love goes with joy? Listen to this. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love. Even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in His love. These things have I spoken unto you. Listen, that my joy might remain in you. Listen, and that your joy might be full. You want to be full of joy? Know the love of God. Yeah. Love Him. How do I love God? Jesus said, if you love me, you keep my commandments. Listen, He died for us. He loved us enough to die for us. We ought to love Him enough to live for Him. Somebody say amen. Amen. I mean, that's right. And that's what the Lord's saying here the night before He goes to the cross. He said, I want you to abide in my love. And I want you to abide in the Father's love. And He says, I want my joy to be in you. And I want you to be full of joy. And listen, there's times when we have sorrow. The Lord even said it over there in our scripture that we read. He said, you'll have sorrow. He said, I go back to the Father. And He says, you're going to have sorrow. Matter of fact, a little bit later on, He said, in the world you have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I've overcome the world. And it's almost a paradox to say, how can I be sorrowful and yet have joy? But it's so. It's so. In this life, there'd be times when we'll be sorrowful. You go to the funeral home, and you know, you're sorrowful because your loved one is there at the funeral home and everything, and it's not goodbye, it's just so long for now. But you realize that. And so there's a flickering joy that abides in there, knowing, praise God, that our Lord Jesus Christ made a way for us to go home to be with Jesus, and we'll all be together over on the other side. So we still have that joy, and that joy can be full in us. We can be full of joy while we work for the Lord. We've got a lot of works going on here at the church. Praise God, because that's what He saved us unto. He saved us unto good works. You're not saved because you do good works. We do good works because we're saved. Amen. Amen. But He's enabled us to do that. We've got a lot of works. But listen, when we do the works of the Lord, when we minister in the nursing homes, when we do the Samaritan's Purse shoeboxes, when we sing in the Christmas cantata, whatever that is, whatever work that we have going on, we can be full of joy while we do it. It's a joy to serve the Lord. Amen. Well, that's right. My sister Kathy, my other sister Kathy back there, praise God. Listen, it's a joy to serve the Lord. My brother Mike, my other brother Mike. It's a joy to serve Jesus. Did you know that? I mean, listen, praise God. The Bible says we count it all joy, even if we suffer for Him. Apostle Paul said, even if we suffer for Him, we count that all to be joy, to suffer for the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen to what he said. He said, these things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. He said, this is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. How much did Jesus love us? Enough to die for. Matter of fact, listen to what he says in the next verse, verse 13. Greater love hath no man than this, than that a man lay down his life for his friends. Now that's love. If you're going to bite and devour one another and talk ugly about people behind their backs and those kind of, you know what? There's no love in that. None. That's absent of love. Matter of fact, that's hate. And can I just tell you, we're living in the United States of America, and right now this country is slam full of hate. People hate one another. So divided. I mean division. They hate them because they're a Democrat. They hate them because they're a Republican. They hate them because they're a liberal. They hate them because they're a conservative. They hate them because of this. They hate them because of that. Congress hates each other. It kills them to have to come together on anything because it looks like they're caving into the other side. We elect them, they go up there, and they can't work together. Now they can't even get a Speaker of the House. It's in chaos. People out here wanting to kidnap governors and execute them. Why? Because they want them to wear a mask during the pandemic. They trying to help people. They want to just kidnap people. They want to execute them. They want to hang the vice president, they said. A man from Clay County up here took 23 rounds of ammunition up there to Washington, D.C. with the purpose of killing the Speaker of the House of Representatives. He's doing 3 years in prison for it right now. Yeah. Hatred. And all time, the Bible, the Word of God in the red letters, and Jesus is saying this. He said, verse 12, this is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Do you see that? That ye love one another as I have loved you. You want your joy to be full? Get rid of some of that old hatred, ugliness that's in your heart. I don't know why I'm preaching this morning. And get some love. There's a song, the old timers used to sing a song years ago. It's in the old red back hymnal. It said, when Jesus took my heart all to pieces and he let a little sunshine in. Huh? Amen. Give me that old time religion. Makes me love everybody. Makes me love everybody. And it's good enough for me. I'm talking about the old timer, born again, saved by grace, blood washed, heaven bound with a hammer down, saints of Almighty God that loves the Lord, amen, and loves one another because that's what He compelled us to do. I'm talking about your joy being full. You say, well, I just say so down and so depressed and everything. You better guard your joy, friend, because I'm telling you, the devil's a thief. He wants to steal your joy. And the world wants to steal your joy away. Come on. Amen. Your own flesh will steal your joy if you ain't careful. Back to John 16. Listen to what he says. Verse 22. And ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again. Why can I have joy? Because I know Jesus is coming soon. Morning, night, or noon. And people come up to you and say, boy, things sure are bad right now, aren't they? I mean, things is bad, ain't they? Yeah, they're bad, but they're fixing to get better. I told a man on the square up there in Hayesville here not long ago, come up there and he said, boy, Derek, things sure are bad, ain't they? I said, yeah, but they're fixing to get better. He said, I hope you're right. I said, brother, I can tell you on the authority of the Word of God, things is going to get better.
Amen.
Yeah. I said, my Lord's coming back, and things are going to get better. Yeah, can I just tell you that if the rapture took place right now, and I believe in the rapture of the church, by the way, and if you don't, you come see me. I'll show you where it's in the Bible in many places. Several raptures have already taken place. Enoch was raptured. He's walking with the Lord. The Lord just took him on home. Elijah was raptured. Yeah. He gave his coat to Elisha, and the Lord come and got him. Took him out of here. Jesus was raptured. He stood up there on the Mount of Olives, and a cloud received him out of their sight. Apostle Paul was raptured. He said he was called up to the third heaven. John was raptured. He heard a voice said, come up hither. I see seven raptures in the Bible. Two more yet to take place. The next one's going to be the rapture of the church. Whew. We're going out of here. God's not going to suffer his little bride to go through this awful tribulation that's getting ready to happen. You see this stuff that's happening in Israel? You think that's bad? It's a drop in the bucket compared to what's coming. This world is being conditioned, by the way, for the tribulation. The world is being conditioned for the tribulation. The church is being conditioned for the rapture. The saints are aware. We're listening for the shout. We're listening for the trumpet. We're getting ready to go home. The saints of every nation shall lose their gravitation and in the middle of the air be caught away. Praise God. We're going up to be with Jesus. But then there's one more after that. There's two witnesses that are coming in Revelation chapter 11 that are come down here and preach the Word of God right in the middle of the tribulation. They'll kill them, and their bodies will lay in the middle of the street. 3 days. And they'll be resurrected, and then they're going out. Two more raptures yet to take place. That's deep. Yeah, it's deep, praise God. Get in the Word of God and enjoy it. Amen. You know what enjoy means? It means to attach yourself to joy. Lay hold on it. You sit down with a bowl of ice cream, say, here's you some ice cream, enjoy it. Attach yourself to the joy of eating that ice. Listen, attach your joy to enjoying reading the Word of God. Get it in your heart. Enjoy it. Amen. Listen, there's joy to be had. But now I want you to listen to what our Lord said, and I've got to hurry. Verse 22, chapter 16, and ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again. Listen at this. And your heart shall rejoice. Listen at this. And your joy no man taketh from you. The world can take a lot of things away from me. They can't take Jesus out of my heart, Brian.
Amen.
Praise God. They can't steal my joy. Amen. God wants us. He wants us to have joy. And if we don't have joy, it's because we say no thank you to it. It's available to us. You can be born again and saved by the grace of Almighty God, and you can get the Holy Ghost living in you, and you can have joy. Not only that, but you can have a whole lot of other things too. I'm talking about the Lord said bear much fruit. What fruit? Hold your place right here and go forward with me over to Galatians chapter number 5. And listen to what is available to you this morning. This is available to you today. And you say, well, you know, I go home and I watch Fox News and I just see how bad things are and everything, and then I just get the mully grubs and everything, and I just get the pooch mouth, and all I want to do is just listen. That thing's got an off button. I told Brother Larry, like me and Larry was talking on the phone last night, I told him, I said, praise God for that button on that remote control, that big red one, I can turn that thing off, huh? I can go outside and listen to the birds sing a while. In through the nose, out through the mouth, and say, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Listen, Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. But the fruit of the Spirit, listen to me, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. You know what temperance is? Self-control. A lot of people need that nowadays. Yeah, meekness, temperance. This says, against such there is no law. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. God wants you to have love and peace and joy. Amen. He wants these things for you. How bad do you want it? Or would you rather go out here and get marred up to your eyeballs in the things of the world? Charlotte and I were at a place the other morning, and it's playing music over the loudspeaker, and it's so depressing. This I hadn't listened to a lot of modern music in a long time. But they're playing this stuff, and I told Charlotte, I said, that's music to die by right there. Huh? Be careful, little ears, what you hear. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little mouth, what you say. You know? Listen, and you've got a choice to make this morning. God bless your heart. I love you today. But if you want to stay mad at the whole wide world with your lip run out and run around here and be so daggone depressed and down in the mouth on everything and everybody all the time, that's your business. You do that if that's what you want to do. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. Yeah. I'm going to say praise God anyway. Amen. And I'm going to say, Lord, give me. Lord, I pray, God, give me joy. Give me peace. Give me love. And He's not going to say no. You know why? Because He wants me to have peace and joy and love. He wants the good things for you. He wants you to have the good things in this life. Do you hear me? You say, well, I know, but they are doing this and they're doing that and these are doing this and that and they and everything. Listen, worry looks around, okay? I can look around every day, all day, and worry myself to death. Faith looks up. Faith says, lift up your head, your redemption draweth nigh. Praise God, heaven's real and folks really goes there, and I'm going there. Amen. This world is not my home, by the way. I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. We don't walk by feelings. We walk by faith. But you want to talk about the precious intangible things that your money can't buy? Love. Peace, joy, grace, mercy, faith, hope. Praise God. I'd rather have that. What am I saying this morning? I'd rather have Jesus than anything this world affords today. That's right. Where are you at this morning? Let me ask you, do you have real joy? Do you have any real joy in your life, or is it all just, listen, you can go back in that same chapter, Galatians 5, and if you're experiencing a lot of the things that it mentions as the works of the flesh, hatred, variance, jealousy, envy, strife, murder, seditions, lust, fornication, adulteries, all these kind of things. If you're experiencing all these kind of things in your life, maybe it's time to come to Jesus and get the fruit of the Spirit going on in your life. Maybe it's time that you start having some real joy in your life.